don't you stand on your feet with us? Put your hands together with us.
That he's a good, good father, amen. We just praise you tonight, oh God. You're worthy of all the praise, Jesus. Just lift your hands in this place tonight. We thank you, Lord, for being a good, good father. Hallelujah.
Healed. Thank you. Father God. Lord, we're worshiping you this evening, Father God. We are glorifying your name, Father God, because you are worthy, Father God. We exalt, we magnify the name of Jesus the Christ, amen? And we come here to praise and worship him, amen? And we need to stay in the attitude of worship, because God is worthy, amen? And he created us for worship, to know him, amen? And so let's give God the glory, amen? Let's just begin giving praise. Can we give him 5 minutes? Can we give him 5 minutes? Oh, hallelujah. Shanda la baba nidaba shanda. Shanda la baba nidaba shanda. Shanda la baba nidaba shanda. Come on, you can do better than that. You can do better. You're not clapping for me. You're clapping for him, amen? He's worthy. He's worthy. He's worthy. He's worthy. He's worthy. He's worthy. And his name is Jesus. His name is Jesus. His name is Jesus.
Jesus.
Oh, hallelujah. Oh, be glorified. Holy Spirit, have your way. Help us to decrease so that you can increase. Be glorified. Take over this service for your glory. Prepare our hearts to receive what has to be said. Prepare our hearts to what you have to tell us. Father God, we stand against any distraction, any confusion, Father God. I pray we come expecting you to move this evening. And Father God, we're going to worship you. And we're going to adore you. And we give you the glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. And amen. God bless you. God bless you. Hallelujah. He's worthy. Come on up, Sister Gabby. Praise you.
Good evening. Anybody need a physical healing? Come on up. Come on up. He says, keep on asking. Keep on seeking. He inhabits the praises of his people. Come on down. Come on down, Father. Down. If you need healing, expect him. Believe on his promises. We walk by faith, not by sight. Come on, God. Come on, heal this.
Go back.
Heal.
Can't go back.
Okay. Let's have prayer warriors. Come on down behind these. Come on, let's pray for them.
Your presence came and
the Lord says the prayer of the righteous availeth much. Come on. Come on down. Pray. Pray, Lord.
Can't go back.
Pray, Lord, Father, in Jesus' name, Lord. We thank you for this night, Lord. Thank you for coming into our presence, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Come, come, Lord. Lord, in Jesus' name, heal this night. Lord, we ask you would heal depression. You would heal bone diseases. You would heal muscular diseases. You would heal the organs in the body, Lord, that you would heal our brains, Lord, that you would heal depression, that you would heal autoimmune diseases. You would heal cancer, Lord, in Jesus' name tonight. We believe, Lord, and your word says it. Let it be done, Lord. Heal in Jesus' name. Heal, Lord. Anoint, Lord, in Jesus' name. Lift it off these people, Lord. Holy Spirit, come, come. Mighty God, heal, heal, Lord. We thank you. We thank you for what you're going to do tonight. Thank you, Lord. Praise your mighty name. Glory, glory to you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. By your stripes we are healed. Heal, Lord, in Jesus' name. From the top of their heads to the bottom of their feet, Lord, in Jesus' name. Heal, Lord. Heal, Lord. Heal the unspoken, Lord. Heal those that couldn't come up, Lord, in Jesus' name. Heal, Lord. Give us signs and wonders. Give us miracles this night. Lord, help them to receive the healing you have for them this night, Lord. We thank you. We thank you, Lord. We receive what you have for us this night, Lord. We thank you. We praise your name. Glory to you, Lord. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Heal, heal. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. Bless them, Lord. Bless them. In Jesus' name, heal. Heal, Lord. Lift them up, Lord. In Jesus' name. Raise them up, Lord. Give give them strength, Lord. Heal. Heal, Lord. Heal before it even comes, Lord, in Jesus' name. Give them wisdom, Lord, in Jesus' name. Help them to receive this, what you have for them this night, Lord. You are a healing God, a merciful God. We thank you, Lord. We thank you for what you've already done. We thank you for what you're going to do, Lord. We thank you right now. Receive your healing. Come on, tell him you receive it. Praise God. Praise God. Glory to God.
No one else can touch my heart like you do.
The Word of God says he still heals.
I have searched through all eternity.
Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Come on, come on, come on. Oh, hallelujah. Let's get excited. Oh, God is performing miracles, amen. God is performing miracles, amen. God is making us whole. God is healing our bodies, amen. God is delivering us. God is setting us free right now. He said, if you have faith the size of a mustard seed, you can speak to the mountain of your life.
I can search for
amen. Let's give him praise. Amen. He's worthy. Amen. He's worthy. Praise God. God bless the praise team. We love you guys. Hopefully one of these days I can sing like that. Amen. Praise God. God bless you. You may be seated if you can. Amen. Praise God. I'm going to have Sister Debbie Goodman to come up and she's going to do an announcement. Can we give her a hand? Amen.
Hi, I'm Life Minister Debbie Goodman. That's Pastor Dave Richardson there. Thank you for coming tonight. Welcome. Do we have any visitors tonight? Anybody? All right. Give them a big Sheffield welcome. Look, over here. Awesome. Keep asking. Bring someone to church. Come on. Bring them to church. Praise God. Can we have our ushers come up with debit envelopes, please? Anybody needs a debit envelope? They're passing them out. Praise God. Praise God. Everybody got those. Okay, got some announcements for you tonight. Men's ministry breakfast will be this Saturday, July 23rd, in the gym at 9 a.m. Women at the Well Ministry is celebrating our one-year anniversary on Saturday, July 23rd at 11 a.m. at Sheffield West, 1215 Benton. Please join us for songs, poetry, dance, testimonies, and, of course, food and fellowship. We hope to see you there. Come on, come, go. The Women's Sunday School class, Lies Women Believe and the Truth That Sets Them Free, begins August 7th at 9 a.m. in Koinonia B.A. Please contact Pat Washington for more information. Okay, it's time to give to God. Praise the Lord. Come on. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Praise God. Come on, Lord. He says in Malachi, to bring all the tithes into the storehouse. Bring everything. Offerings are over tithes. And then there are alms that help your brethren out. So give. Give with a willing heart. He doesn't need the money, but he wants you to have a giving heart in everything you do. So give. Give with love. In Jesus' name. So we thank you, Father. Lord, bless this offering. We thank you, Lord, for it. Bless each one. Lord, let this go for your glory and for the kingdom of God. Lord, let it reach out. In Jesus' name, we thank you. Amen. Okay.
Can we give Sister Debbie a hand? Amen. Praise God. I appreciate Sister Debbie. I met Debbie about 14 years ago. She came out. If you guys that don't know, I do a street ministry on Friday nights. And she came out. We were doing an outreach over in Kansas. And I didn't know who she was. She had been calling, trying to find out where we was at. She was lost for probably an hour or something. But anyway, she finally made it. But when she... to me. So we were doing the outreach and we were on the war wagon, the yellow truck in the back, and I'm trying to figure out why this white woman keep watching me. And she was just standing over there and she wasn't saying that. And I'm like, it's starting to make me uncomfortable. You know, and she just stood there up under the tree and never identified herself. And I'm like, man, okay, what's up with this? And then she finally introduced herself 14 years ago. She's been with us ever since and she's been a blessing. She's been healed of cancer. How many times have you been? 3 times she's been healed of cancer. And it's amazing because she would, we would do an outreach and she would come out after she didn't have chemo surgery. I mean, chemo treatments. And I'm like, are you kidding me? You know, I shut it down for a toothache. You know, and so I admire her. She has a servant's heart. She just wants to serve God. Amen. You know, and even though in her body she had sickness and disease, she was still serving God, amen? And now she's a miracle. Her wig done grew back, amen? Yeah, so I just thank God for her. But my name is Brother Dave Richardson. I am an associate pastor with Pastor Mike at Sheffield West. We've been having services since August of last year, and God's just been doing a remarkable thing over at Sheffield West. And I encourage you just to come by and visit and see what God is doing, amen. Most of the congregation is made up of homeless people, and I love it because God said, go and make disciples of all nations, amen. And he tells us to go get them, amen. And so when they come in, they smell funny, they look funny, and they said the same thing about me, amen. And so we just embrace them and love them, because I believe God's going to raise up people like that in that community to reach this city, amen? People that nobody cares about, people that have been cast to the side, God's going to raise them up for his glory, amen? Because God is all about glory, you know what I'm saying? And what God want to do is work in that impossible. You know, nobody could ever told me that I would be up here speaking, but God works in the impossible, you know what I'm saying? And I feel like God made me out of spare parts, amen? But God take the impossible, amen? You know, and just for some of you guys that are wondering, I will dispel your myth, okay? I'm not Stevie Wonder. I'm not Malcolm X. I'm not Jim Jones. And I'm not blind, okay? So let me destroy your myth, okay? I am all good. This is who I am, amen? This is who I am. And what I do for God, amen? You know what I'm saying? So you ain't got to wonder. And for you ladies, I promise you I won't steal your purse, amen? You're good, okay? Praise God. I love Jesus, amen? I love Jesus. I've been going here since 91 when it was across the street. And when I started going, a young lady invited me. And I know it had to be God because the church was like 99.9% white. And I'm like, I felt like I had stepped into the Twilight Zone. But, you know, I love the guy that was talking, the guy with the red socks. This is Honor Pastor Westlake, okay? I know y'all miss him, so he's with us in spirit, amen? But I love what he was saying, and that was the first church I went to where the guy challenged you to open up the Bible. I done been to churches where they shouting and hoop, and they ain't said nothing. But he spoke out the word, and even though I didn't want to go back because it was like 99% non-white, I kept going back. And then this old boy got kind of crazy. I started sitting up in the front row. I'm like, are you kidding me? It's got to be God. You know what I'm saying? And I committed my life to Christ on 12/12/91. I went forward. I got baptized twice because I wanted to get this thing right. Pastor Fell baptized me, but I told him I don't want to get my wig wet, so I wore one of them caps. Amen. And when I accepted Christ, I just became radical. You know what I'm saying? Nobody was there to explain to me, you know, when you accept Christ, what happened. And I just wanted to tell everybody about Jesus. I got involved with the street ministry, the nursing home ministry, the youth ministry, Rainbows, the prison ministry. The only ministry they wouldn't let me in was the women's ministry. Amen. I was in like 8 ministry. And I'm not trying to say that to be boastful. I'm just saying when I accepted Christ, God put a passion in me. A zeal, and I just had to tell somebody. Amen. And the guys on my job thought I was crazy because I lived by myself, so there was nobody at home for me to torment. And I just wanted to tell people about Jesus. And I didn't know what I was saying, but I was excited. And I'm like, let me tell you about this God that changed my life. I mean, you're looking at a straight up thug, and he changed my life. And I just wanted to tell everybody about Jesus. And I was going to the clubs, I was going to the liquor store, I was passing out tracts, I was chasing people down. I mean, it was my mission to find Jehovah Witness. I was looking for them. You know what I'm saying? And I was giving I was just radical. You know, I was that nut. If you drove behind me in my truck, you couldn't even see out the window because it was all bumper stickers. Jesus Christ is coming. Jesus Christ is away. But you know what? I didn't get filled with religion. I got filled with the Spirit of God. It wasn't about the church, amen? It wasn't about, hey, let me tell you about what denomination I was. It wasn't about that. I had an encounter with Jesus Christ, and he changed me, amen? And in Acts chapter 1, he said, when the Spirit of God come on you, you should be witnesses. You know what I'm saying? So what we're going to talk about today is the Holy Spirit, because you cannot say that you have accepted Christ in your heart and the Spirit of God lives in you and you're not telling somebody. You know what I'm saying? Because there ain't no secret age of Christians, amen? And I guarantee you what, let me tell you something. Come closer. It's getting dark. You know what? The enemy is not going to allow you to remain neutral anymore. He's going to force you out. And either you're going to take a stand for Christ or you're going to cave. Amen? See, all that flying below the radar, that's out. Because we live in a world right now where they're going to challenge you on what you believe. And if you're not grounded in the Holy Spirit, you ain't going to make it. And ain't no use of telling people, well, I go to Sheffield in. What that mean? Have you had an encounter with him? Are you spirit-filled? See what I'm saying? Don't tell me how much you go to church. You go to church all your life and still go to hell. That, have you had a personal encounter with Jesus Christ? Do you know him? Because he said in the last days, some are going to say, we did this in your name, we did that in your name. What are you going to say? I never knew you. Depart from me, you workers of iniquity. He's talking about relationship. God don't want to date you. He's talking about relationship. You can't say, some of y'all just met me, I just didn't. You can't say you know me. You don't know me. You know somebody you hang out with. You know somebody you commune with and you spend time with. You know somebody you listen to and you're around and you can empathize with them. God said, I never knew you. You was in church every Sunday. You sung in the choir and I never knew you. I never knew you. And we live in a world where everybody's stepping up their game except church folk, except the body of Christ. See, let me tell you a little secret. We're sitting back complaining how bad the world is right now. The darkness is doing what it's supposed to do. And guess what Pastor Westlake say? Cheer up, it's going to get worse here. But what is the light doing? Are you being the salt of the earth? Do you unplug your light when you go outside? You are the light of the world. God said, you are the salt of the earth. What's the purpose of salt? Huh? To heal. To convict. What's the purpose of light? See, in this room, we all are light. And so it doesn't matter. Everybody in this room has a flashlight. So what? Go in the darkness and shine your light. And everybody in this room has a ministry. If you've accepted Jesus Christ, matter of fact, let me change that. If you've accepted Jesus Christ, you are a minister of the gospel of Jesus Christ. Man didn't choose me. God said, I chose you. for such a time. God said, you didn't choose me. I chose you. And when I accepted Christ, I said, you know what? I want to be a pastor. I don't know what that meant. It sounds good. I want to be a pastor. So I went through Sheffield School of the Bible, and I got my certification. My Lord's grade was a B plus. I couldn't even draw crayons. But in Bible college, God had a call on my life. Amen? See what I'm saying? And I want to say that because some of y'all look at me like I just walked in off the street. See, I've been serving God all my life. And guess what? My fire ain't going out because I love Jesus, because I know I was hell bound. See, some of you guys are blessed. Some of you guys grew up with parents. I didn't have any parents growing up. So I didn't have that relationship. And when I used to hear people say, God is my father and God is my dad, that sounds weird to me. What do you mean he's your daddy? What do you mean he's your father? But guess what? After so many years of serving him, I get it. That's my daddy. And what I do for him. So, whether you say, hey, Brother Dave, I enjoyed your service, or you did, big deal. God enjoyed it because it's all for him. What I do for him. Amen? I do for him. And if you're waiting on man to tell you to go, you'll never go. God didn't tell you to go. He said, go make disciples of all nations. The last command he gave disciples was to go. Not to say to talk about how good the choir is. Oh, man, did you hear Pastor Joy? Now, let's go home and eat our chicken. Now, what are you doing with what God has given you? And if it was all about salvation, God would have got you saved and killed you. God has given you an assignment. Let me ask you a question. How is heaven better because you're saved? Answer that. How is heaven better because you're saved? See, God has given us assignment. The Bible says today is the day for salvation. See, God, on your job, in your home, in your neighborhood, that's your mission field. You don't have to go to Africa to preach the gospel. You can preach it in the Northeast area. See, you, wherever you are in your life is your mission field. See what I'm saying? Well, I don't know a ministry. Well, step out. Because what I say is God will only hit a moving target. If you're moving for God, God will show you what he wants you to do. But if you're sitting there watching Oprah all day, you probably won't hear a thing. But the devil. Amen? But if you're moving and you're acting for God and you're going after God and you're going after things of God, God's going to show you the call of God on your life. He's going to show you that. That's why he said the harvest is plentiful, but the workers are few. See, we sitting back talking about how good church was. And people dying, going to hell every day. I do a street ministry. We go out Friday nights every Friday. We meet at 5 o'clock for prayer. We pray from 5 to 6. Then it's boots on the ground. The ministry called Soldiers of the Cross. We're soldiers for Jesus Christ. And I encourage you, I challenge you to come out with us. And don't worry about it. God watches over us when we're out there. And you can get cussed out in Price Chopper. Amen. So don't say, well, I don't want nobody to cuss me out on the street. You get cussed out in Quick Trip. Take somebody's pump. See, so time out for the excuses, amen? And you need to ask the Holy Spirit to search your heart. And God, what are you calling me to do right now? What are you calling me to do? Ephesians chapter 1 say God has given us every spiritual blessing in the heavenly realms. So let me correct your theology. For you to say, God bless me, God said, I've already blessed you. I've already given you everything you need to serve me. Everything. You don't need another great awakening. God said, everything you need, I've already given it to you in the spiritual realm. Here's our problem. We're on the earthly level. We're on the earthly level. We're trying to figure God out with our flesh. And our flesh is wicked. See, God said, everything you need, I've already given it to you. Everything you need. So what are you waiting on? What are you waiting on? If you're waiting on your flesh, the situation will never be right. Amen? It would never. The enemy's going to see to that. And I thank God that I was crazy enough to step out when he got a hold of me. And I done calmed it down a little bit. I ain't as radical as I was, because there was people that really wanted to do some bad things to me. But thank God, God's hands was on me. Amen? Praise God. Praise God. And some of y'all still looking like, what are you talking about? Talk to God about it, amen? Talk to God. And don't be like, Dave, I need to talk to you after the service. No, you do not. Okay. What I want to do is I want to give you a book last year, maybe 3 years ago, we started doing some training on prayer. And I have read a lot of books. I love to read. I love books. But I have never read anything as powerful as this. And one of them, the yellow book, talks about praying for people that are lost. And it gets into great detail on why people don't respond. You know, you talk to a family member or a coworker or a neighbor or a spouse. And this guy goes into great detail biblically and in his opinion on why people don't respond to the gospel. And in this book here, it deals with you living an exceeding abundant life. We need to embrace that all God has for us. In John 10:10, God said, I've come to give you abundant life, life overflowing. Amen. So either God lied or we're not stepping out in faith. So I want to give you one of those, one per couple, please, because I want everybody to give one, and then each individual can give one. And if you didn't get one, let me know, and we'll get you a book. But I challenge you to read it. This is going to change your walk, I guarantee you. And I just want you to come back and tell me how it's blessed you. Amen. Praise God. Now, we're going to get into the lesson why they pass out those booklets. Let's turn to John chapter 14. John chapter 14. And while you're turning, excuse me, I want to thank Pastor Westlake. I want to thank Pastor George. And I want to thank Pastor Mike for giving me the opportunity to minister on the Wednesday. Amen. So I want to thank them. And let's pray for all three of those pastors because they are out of town. Praise God. Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm. But this book, both of these books, the man that wrote both of these books and the town he's from,
I was a little crazy man like Dave was. I was out in the world acting a fool, acting crazy. Now, Dave, you didn't know this. May the 1st, 1955, I was in this Westlake, Louisiana. May the 1st. About 1:30 in the morning, acting a fool, and I got shot. I got hit 3/4 of an inch from the heart and was supposed to die in 1955, 61 years ago. And this is why these books bless me. So I've read both books. But this is a testimony to me that God can use you, but you got to want God to use you. All right? I'm an outlaw. That's my last name. And a lot of people thought I was one because I was out there acting a fool. But you have got to want God to use you. God's not going to make you do nothing. He want to find out how much we really love him. And the only way we can do that is by doing what Brother Dave said. Amen?
Praise God. Give Brother Al our hand. Praise God. Praise God. Real quick, let's go to John chapter 14. Verse 12 through 18. And this evening, we're going to be talking about the Holy Spirit. How many of us know we need more power in our life? Amen? We need more power. We need the Spirit of God to empower us to do what he's called us to do. But the call of God on your life cannot be done in your flesh. The call on your life has to be carried out by the Holy Spirit. Amen? And Jesus said, I'm going to send you a comforter, a counselor. You know, there was a story I heard about a young lady dealing with the power company, and they couldn't figure out why her bill was so low. And so they went to her house, and it was like, check the meter, make sure everything worked. Come to find out what she was doing, she would turn her lights on long enough just to light a candle, then turn the lights back out. And she was not utilizing the power that she has. And that's us. And Pastor West, like I said, we are a power-packed package, amen, with the Holy Spirit. The same Spirit that rose Jesus up from that grave dwells within you if you made a confession of Jesus Christ. That same Spirit that spoke the world into existence lives in you, amen? Because the Bible says in Genesis 1 that the Spirit of God hovered over the earth. That same Spirit dwells in you, amen? I mean, you have all that power available to you, and then we choose to live our life in our own strength. And the enemy loves that, amen? He loves when you try to use religion to try to defeat him. You know what I'm saying? And here we are trying to defeat an enemy that we can't even see. you know, and he loves that. But God has given us power. And the reason why I say that is because we come here on Wednesday, we come here on Sunday, and then next week we do it all over again. And God said, I've come to give you abundant life, life overflowing. He said, I come to give you abundant life. Jesus said, the works that I did, you shall do greater works. Are you kidding me? He said, the works that I did, you should do greater works. What did Jesus do? Oh, he only raised the dead. He only fed 5,000 people with a Big Mac and an order of fries. What did Jesus? Oh, he only walked on water. He only told the waves, be still. He didn't do much, did he? He said, the works I did, you shall do greater works. He said, wait until you are dude with power and you shall be witnesses. A witness is somebody that's able to communicate and articulate what they've experienced and what they've seen. See? And let me tell you a little secret. I mean, you probably don't know this. Nobody can tell your story better than you can. Amen? Nobody can beat you at your story. And here we are, we don't want to say anything. The Bible said they overcame by the blood of the Lamb and the word of their testimony. Amen? But see, in order to have this, in order to demonstrate this, you have to have a personal, active relationship with Jesus Christ. You can't be a Sunday saint and a Monday ain't. Don't work. Don't work. Amen? And I can tell you what, if you're going to mentor somebody, the only way you can mentor somebody is what's in you. You can't give them something you don't have. So if you don't have joy, you can't speak joy over them. If you don't have peace, you can't speak peace over them. You can't because you don't have it in you. And I can tell you what, during the street ministry, since 1994, people can tell when you're faking the funk. They can tell when you don't believe what you're telling me. You know what I'm saying? Somebody would talk to you and they tell you something and you can tell they don't even believe it. I'm like, hurry up, go ahead. And let me tell you something. When Jesus fasted for 40 days and 40 nights, the Bible said the Holy Spirit sent him into the wilderness. And it said the devil tempted him. And the devil said, if you are, or since you are, turn these stones into bread. How did Satan know Jesus was hungry? Did he get an email? How did he know Jesus was hungry? He was watching him. He studies him. He studied him. Guess what? He studies us. He knows our weakness. He knows how to get you caught up. Satan ain't got to create no new attack on you. Why? The old stuff still works. He studies us. He know, and you keep saying, man, why that keep happening? Because you haven't wised up and start relying on the Spirit of God. See? So you, whether you like it or not, you're in this game called life. And whether you want to play or not, it's not up to you. You have to decide on whether you want to be a casualty or not. Amen? See, so if you're going to be in the game, you might as well win the game. Because guess what? Jesus said, I've conquered hell. I've defeated them. You're not fighting for victory. You're fighting from victory. There's a difference. He said, I've conquered it. He said, I've taken the sting out of death. See? So the only one that's treating the enemy like a winner is us. Because he's been defeated. He got the email. He's been defeated. And he said, when you've done all you can do, what? Stand. When you've done all you can do, stand. But whether you say, well, Dave, I don't want to play that game, it ain't up to you. When you were born, you became a part of this game called life. And here's the problem. You're going to be influenced by the spirit of light or the spirit of darkness. You can't stand here and say, leave me alone. I don't want to play that game. It's not up to you. Until you can make a confession to Jesus Christ, you are fair game. See what I'm saying? So you're going to be, everything we do, we're being influenced by the spirit of God or the spirit of darkness. Everything we do. You're like a chess piece. But when we accepted Jesus Christ, when we surrounded Jesus Christ, guess what? He paid it all. See what I'm saying? And say, in order to get to me, you got to get through him. You got to get through God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. And I want to see you try. I'm going to stand right here. Amen. Praise God. Let's go to John chapter 14, verse 12. Very truly, I tell you, whoever believes in me, and believe means to act on. Believe not, I believe. How many people came in here and sat down and inspected the chair before they sat down? Anybody? You know what? You put belief in that chair can hold you, right? Because you sat down, right? So belief means to act on. Well, I believe in God. Well, do your feet match your words? Amen? I believe God is a way maker. Come on. So he said, very truly, I tell you, whoever believes in me will do the works I have been doing. And they will do even greater things than these. Because I am going to the Father. And I will do whatever you ask me in my name. What? Let me read that again. My glass is kind of clouded up. And I will do whatever you ask me in my name, so that the Father may be glorified in the Son. You may ask me for anything in my name, and I will do this. Are you kidding me? I can ask God for anything? Let's go down to verse 15. If you love me, keep my commands, and I will ask the Father, and he will give you another advocate to help you and be with you forever. I will give you somebody to come alongside of you. I will give you somebody to come alongside of you, to be with you, wherever you go. Wherever you go, he's with me. This is my Holy Spirit. This is my Holy Spirit. It's my Holy Spirit. He said he would be with me and in me. Wherever I go, he's with me, amen? Wherever I go, he's with me, and he's in me. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Yeah, he said he would be in me, and he would be with me. Amen? The Spirit, he said, whatever you ask for in my name, it shall be given. Everything Jesus prayed for, the Father met that need. Everything. God the Father never told Jesus, let me get back with you. So what's our problem? See, our prayers need to be lined up with the will and the word of God. See, we're praying for stuff that God don't want us to have. Or God wants to grow us up. Or God wants us to mature, whatever it is. But he say, whatever you ask for in my name, so that the Father may be glorified in the Son, you may ask me for anything in my name, and I will do it. Boom. See, that's relationship. That's relationship. And I will ask the Father, and he will give you another advocate to help you and be with you forever. The Spirit of truth. We got a lying spirit in the earth, amen? This is the Spirit of truth. The world cannot accept him because it neither sees him nor knows him. But you know him, relationship. For he lives with you and will be in you. How many of us, I mean, just think about that. Do you live your life knowing that the Holy Spirit is in you? Wherever you go, whatever you do, some of us going to have to start changing some of the places we go to. Because wherever you go, God's going with you. This bud is for you, amen? Huh? The Holy Spirit, but you know what? That gives me confidence. See, the only way I can do this is by the power of the Spirit of God. You know, and some of you guys can't tell, but if I'm not talking about God, I am an introvert. You'll find me somewhere in the corner because I am very insecure in who I am, in myself. Amen? And when I start to talk about Jesus, there's a boldness that comes on me. And I don't care what people think, and I don't care what you say. I'm not going to apologize for my love for Jesus Christ. Everybody get to be offended except us that love the Lord. And what I tell them, you know what? You offended? I'm offended because you offended. Now what? Now what? So now we're both offended. Amen? But the Holy Spirit lives in you. Can you say that? The Holy Spirit lives in me. Forever. How long is forever? Are you kidding me? And when I talk to you, you're telling me I'm trying to make it. You're telling me she made me hit her. Are you kidding me? I can't get over it because you're not yielding to the Spirit of God. You're not yielding. It's got to get from here to here. Amen? Praise God. Let's move on. But you know him, for he lives with you and will be in you. I will not leave you orphans. I will come to you. And Jesus is saying, hey, when the Spirit comes, the Son's coming and the Father's coming. You get all three in one. You get all three in one. So what is it that you're saying I can't deal with? What is it that you're struggling with right now? God is waiting for you to give it to him. God is waiting for you to give it to him. The three of them, God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit resides within you right now. Right now. Let's go to chapter 15, verse 26 and 27. Praise God. When the advocate comes, not if, but when the advocate comes, who I will send to you from the Father, the Spirit of truth. Notice it's the Spirit of truth who goes out from the Father. He will testify about me. And you also must testify, for you have been with me from the beginning. And let me tell you something. If you've accepted Jesus Christ in your heart, and the only time you mention his name is when you hit your finger with a hammer, then you better check whether you got the Spirit of God living in you. Because see, the Holy Spirit goes fanatical over Jesus. The Holy Spirit's primary responsibility is to talk about Jesus. His primary responsibility is to exalt the name of Jesus Christ. That's what he does. He's crazy over Jesus. And you mean to tell me the only time Jesus' name come up is on Christmas? The Holy Spirit said his job is to testify who Jesus is. He said, your job is to testify who Jesus is. So are you testifying? And if you say, Dave, I accepted Christ and Christ lives in my heart, then the Holy Spirit is going to be working you up. Because the Holy Spirit's primary responsibility is to talk about who Jesus Christ is. 24/7. 24/7. That's his job. And he's going to empower you to do that. Amen? Praise God. Let's go to John chapter 16, verse 1 through 15. And I guarantee you, I'll have you out of here before Christ comes back. Amen? Some of y'all already looking at y'all watch. Verse 7. Let's go to verse 7. Chapter 16, verse 7. But very truly I tell you, if for your good that I am going away. And let me give you the context. He's letting the disciples know, I am about to leave you guys. I'm about to depart. And obviously they were sad because they've been with Jesus 3 years or 3.5 years. So he's telling them that if I don't go away, you will not have the comforter. And understand, in the Old Testament, only certain people had the Holy Spirit. Now in the New Testament, everybody can have the Holy Spirit. And Jesus said, if I don't go away, the comforter will not come. You know, he's a comforter. He's a counselor. He's the Spirit of truth. He's the Spirit of holiness. Amen? He's there to come alongside of you and pick you up. He's there to come alongside of you and restore your joy and restore your peace. He's there. He's telling you, you know, don't worry about what you're going to say because I'll give it to you at its proper time. How many of us have begun to say something, and all of a sudden, all this words just started coming out? You're like, man, I don't know where that came from. The Holy Spirit gave it to you, amen? Because we're not that good, amen? But very truly, I tell you, it is for your good that I am going away. Unless I go away, the advocate, the comforter, the counselor will not come to you. But if I go, I will send him to you. When he comes, he will prove the world to be in the wrong about sin and righteousness, and judgment about sin because the people do not believe in me, about righteousness because I am going to the Father where you can see me no longer, and about judgment because the prince of this world now stands condemned. Verse 12, I have much more to say to you, more than you can now bear, but when he, notice it's a he, it's not an it, it's not Star Trek, It's not a cosmic force. He's a third member of the Godhead. It's a he. It's a him. He has emotion. He has intellect. That's why the Bible said, don't grieve the Spirit of God. Don't quench the Spirit of God. Ananias and Sapphira decided they want to lie about giving money to the disciple. And Peter told them, you lied to the Holy Spirit. Then you lied to God. You've lied to God. So it's not an it. It's not touched by an angel. Amen. He's God. He's the third member in the Godhead. Amen. You got the Spirit of God living in you. So he will speak only what he hears. And he will tell you what is yet to come. He will glorify me because it is from me that he will receive what he will make known to you. All that belongs to the Father is mine. That is why I said the Spirit will receive from me what he will make known to you. So Jesus said, he will take from me and give it to you. He will make known what comes from the heart of the Father will be given to you by the Holy Spirit. Amen? And how many of us have a cell phone? If you do not, I'm going to ask you to leave the church. Amen? We all know what this is, right? Phone charger. We all have cell phones. And in order to utilize your phone, what do you have to do with this? And if you don't pre-what? You can set all you want to talk on that. You're not going to get nothing. You can pray. You can fast. But you have to, in order to utilize that phone you have to charge them up. Amen? And you can say, by faith, I'm going to charge it up. I'm going to leave the charger there. I'm going to keep the phone in my pocket. And by faith, that phone is going to charge up. Keep believing, amen? And go use somebody else's phone. So you understand that in order to utilize your cell phone, you have to plug it up and charge it. So why do we feel like that we can live the Christian life and we will not tap into the Spirit of the living God? You know what I'm saying? And I'm not talking about 2 hours on a Sunday. I'm talking about lifestyle. I'm talking about lifestyle. See, and like I told you earlier, God don't want to date you. God don't want to date you. God said, I want you to know me. I want you to hang out with you. I want to be your best friend. I want to talk to you. I want to love on you. I want you to love on me. I don't want to see you once a week. And I forgot to introduce my wife, and she's going to remind me. That's my wife, Kim, over there. She don't want to raise her hand because she don't want to be associated with me. But I tell you what, if I went home once a week, she wouldn't be sitting over there. Or I wouldn't be up here. Amen? I'd be on one of them talk shows. Amen? So we know that an earthly relationship would not work like that. Why do we treat God that way? And we'll talk to everybody but God. Well, man, I got this going on. Man, let me go talk to this brother. And God is standing here like, okay, I'm here whenever you need me. I got this thing figured out. I've already mapped your life out. But if you want to talk to everybody else and call the psychic hotline, you go right ahead. But when you get done, I'm right here. Amen? And so we got to get plugged into God. This is lifestyle. This is not your Bible up above your dashboard or in the bag is not going to get you to heaven. You know what I'm saying? It looks good. It's all faded out by now because of the sun. But you need relationship. And we got to get this word in us, amen? Amen. We got to get it in us. Amen. You know what I'm saying? And we need to tap into the Holy Spirit because we like power. The enemy can rattle our cage and we go running. And I can tell you what, if Christ don't come back for another 100 years, you will be challenging what you believe because it's already happening. And God is trying to get us anchored in him so when the day the trials of testing come, we won't give in. See what I'm saying? Because if somebody talks about us, we run away. Somebody talks about us. And the Holy Spirit is waiting there to serve you. The Holy Spirit is here to serve you. Just like I had my brother follow me around. Wherever you go, he's with you. And God said, call on me and I will answer you. He said, call on me and I will answer you. In Jeremiah 29, God said, I've come to give you abundant. I mean, Jeremiah 29, he said, I've come to give you life overflowing. He said, I know the plans I have for you. Amen. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you hope in the future. He said, when you call on me, I will answer you. God is all about relationship. God is all about relationship. That's why when we go out in the streets, I don't bring up Sheffield unless somebody asks me what church I'm from. Because you know what? It ain't about that. It's about Jesus Christ. Do you know him? Do you know him? Let me tell you about a man that changed my life. Huh? Let me tell you. And you can't argue with me about what God's done in my life. Well, Dave, I don't believe that. So what? It happened to me. How are you going to tell me what happened to me is not real? It happened to me. And it's happened to a lot of you guys. But it's time for us to step it up. Amen? Amen? Praise God. Let's keep it moving. Praise God. Let's go to Acts chapter 1, verse 4. No, it's Acts chapter 1, yeah, verse 4. Praise God. Acts chapter 1, verse 4. On one occasion, while he was eating with them, he gave them this command, not a suggestion. Do not leave Jerusalem, but wait for the gift my Father promised. Notice, he called the Holy Spirit a gift. How many of us like gift? How many of us like gift? Why are you waiting to open it up? Open that up, amen? Praise God. Which you have heard me speak about. For John baptized with water, but in a few days you will be baptized with the Holy Spirit. And let's go down to verse 8. But you will receive power when the Holy Spirit come on you. And you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem and in all Judea and Samaria to the ends of the earth. He said, wait. And that's not sitting there watching your favorite show. No, that's going after God in prayer. That's worshiping God. That's seeking God in prayer and worship. And he said, wait for the promise. But he said, when the Spirit of God come on you, you will receive what? Power. How many of us want power? How many of us want power? Amen. And so this is what I want. This is what I want you to put this image in your head. I want you to charge your cell phone up with this. 220. This is the Holy Spirit. Amen. This one here is you trying to do it yourself. This is the Holy Spirit. Amen. This is the Holy Spirit. It's 220. He want to curl your wig, amen? God want to set you on fire, amen? God want to blow you up. God want to blow you up. This is what God wants you to attach yourself to. He wants you to attach yourself to him. Not to this and that. He wants you to attach yourself to him, amen? This represents the Holy Spirit. This is what he wants us to do. He wants to blow us away. God said, your mind can't even begin all I have for you. He said, no eye has seen, and no mind has conceived all God has in store for you. And let me tell you something. When Jesus Christ comes back someday for the church, and he takes us to be with him, do you realize that forever you're going to be in the presence of God? Do you realize when you go to glory, do you realize that you're going to be with God forever? How long is forever? So what? Guess what? We better start getting some practice on how to worship and serve God now. Because if you're saying, well, Dave, I ain't into all the clapping and the jumping around, then heaven going to be a boring place for you. See? Because God created us for worship. And God said, I'm looking for true worshipers. He said, I'm looking for those that will worship me in spirit and truth. God looking for true worship. He said, I'm seeking for them. You know what that implies? They're hard to find. Okay, I see one over here. Okay, can you move, please? Okay, I see that one. He said, I'm looking for true worshipers, those that are worshiping me in spirit and truth. Spirit, the Holy Spirit, truth. Your attitude, your heart has to be right. Amen? Spirit and truth. Amen. That represents the Holy Spirit. How many of us want the power? How many? Guess what? All you have to do is ask for it. Amen? All you have to do is ask for it. And I'm going to tell you this. I'm going to get to my last verse and close it out so you guys get out. But about 3 months ago, I started praying, and I'm not all super spiritual or nothing, but I started praying. I said, God, I want to bless somebody. And so Price Chopper, Aldi's, Save a Lot, and Dollar General. I said, God, I mean Family Dollar. I said, God, if I walk in the store, I said, if there's somebody I'm supposed to bless and help them with their groceries, put me in their line. And I prayed that about 3 months ago, and for a month straight, every store I went into, that happened. And God reminded me, boy, you better have some money in your pocket. But just something as simple as that, the Spirit of God showed up. That was just a simple prayer. I mean, it's no big deal. But I prayed in every line. And come on, you know, what's the chance of that happening? Every store I go into for a month straight. Huh? Some of y'all looking at me like, I wish you would have came to my store. But for a month straight, that happened. For a month straight. And it wasn't, you know, after I bled, you know, okay, how much he owe, and I paid it. It was, hey, let me tell you, my name's Dave Richardson. I'm from Sheffield. No, I got out there quick as they can. Because God said I would share my glory with no one. You know what I'm saying? But so if you want God to do some of your life, if you want God to do some of your ministry, if you want God to put some of your, all you have to do is ask. He said, you have not because you ask not. Whatever you want God to do in your life right now, you ask. That's why when people came up for prayer, Jesus said, by your stripes, you are healed. So when people come up, it's already done. All we're waiting on is the manifestation. Either I believe that or God is lying. See what I'm saying? He said, whatever you ask for in my name, it shall be given. I believe that. See, I'm not as smart as a lot of you guys, so maybe you're more intellectual than I am. I believe it. I believe every word in that book. I even believe the maps. So God said, whatever you need, whatever you desire me to do, I want to give it to you. Because what I want to do, I want you to be drawn closer to me. And whatever God does in our life is for his glory. It's for his glory. God ain't going to allow you to hit the Powerball because you'll walk away from him. But God allows things to happen in our life because God has drawn us to him. Amen? And you know why the Christian life is hard to live? Because we try to live it in the flesh. I'm going to make myself be blessed. I'm going to make myself be healed. I'm going to make it. Well, you keep making it. God don't want you making it. God wants you trusting. You don't put your faith in man. You put your faith in him. It's difficult. And another reason why it's difficult is because the flesh doesn't want to die. Your flesh will never say yes to God. So the flesh doesn't want to pray. The flesh doesn't want to serve. All right, the flesh is probably saying right now, I wish he shut up. That's your flesh. The flesh is, I wish he hurry up. My turkey is burning. That's your flesh. Your flesh is, I wish Pastor Nicole would sing my song. It's your flesh. But they get on my nerve here. Somebody took my seat. That's your flesh. That's why it's difficult. But when you, how many of us live our life in the spirit? It flows, baby. It flows. It flows. All right, we're going to close out with Acts chapter 2, verse 1 through 4. When the day of Pentecost came, they were all together in one place. So notice they obeyed what he told them to do. Suddenly, a sound like a blowing of a violent wind came from heaven and filled the whole house where they were sitting. They saw what seemed to be tongues of fire that separated and came to rest on each of them. All of them were filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in other tongues as the Spirit enabled them. They got the promise. He said, wait. Amen. And let me tell you something. This is a word of encouragement to you. The only way we can pray, the only way we can read our Bibles, the only way we can come to church, that moment is being initiated by the Holy Spirit. God said, no one can come to me unless the Spirit of God draws him. So anytime you decide I want to pray, anytime you decide I want to read my Bible, anytime you want to go to church, that is being initiated by the Holy Spirit. Your flesh cannot do that. So if you're sitting here and you're saying, man, I need to read my Bible tonight before I go to bed, that has been initiated by the Holy Spirit. If you say, I need to go to church and I need to be on time this time, that's been initiated by the Holy Spirit. If you say, I need to give to miss, whatever you're doing that's glorifying God, it's been initiated by the Holy Spirit. Every time. Because he said, no one can come to me unless the Spirit of God draws him. So just know that you didn't come here by chance. Just know that, well, I'm kind of bored and I don't have nothing else to do, so I might as well go to church. No, God put that thought in you. God put that seed. God planted that seed in your spirit. And God allowed you to make it here safely. See? And some of y'all are saying, well, man, that brother got me wound up. I want to get in ministry. Guess what? That thought has been initiated by the Holy Spirit. Even for you to even think about doing ministry, you just have to respond to that thought. Because the Holy Spirit is a gentle spirit. He's a sweet spirit. But just know, we cannot do what God's called us to do in our own strength. We cannot. And like I said, I do a street ministry. How large is this church? What? 4,000? Something like that? I got 8 people in the street ministry. Are you kidding me? 8 people. And thank God for the women, because I wouldn't have anybody. Thank God for the ladies. 8 people. A church this size, and I got 8 people. I got to pay people to come out. Come on, man. Can I give you $5? See, come on. That's the problem. And that ain't just with the street ministry. Every ministry in this church needs laborers. Every ministry in this church needs laborers. So once again, let me ask you this question as we close. How is heaven better because you're saved? How is heaven better because you're saved? And what are you doing for the kingdom? If Jesus Christ don't come back for the next 100 years, what are you going to do for him? What are you going to do? So what we're going to do, we're going to open up the altars. First of all, we're going to open up for those that say, well, I don't know if I'm really saved. I'm like 99% sure I'm saved. Then you're probably not saved. Amen? And then we're going to have those that want to get a filling of the Spirit. Amen? Those that want to be baptized, we're going to pray for you. Amen? Amen. Don't all y'all get too excited. Amen. So we're going to pray for you. So, young man, can you give me some music back there? Stop playing with your ears. Amen. Praise God. God bless you. Don't you all rush out. We're going to pray for you. I appreciate the opportunity of them allowing me to come and speak. And we need to tap into the Holy Spirit. Amen. He's there to help you. He's a helper. He's an advocate. He's a counselor. He's a comforter. Whatever you need him to be, that's what he is to you. Amen? Amen? Praise God. Praise God. Give God a hand. Praise God. So, to not put anybody on Front Street, but if you have not made a confession to Jesus Christ, I encourage you to come down so we can pray with you. Amen? And can I get some altar workers, please? In Romans chapter 10, verse 9 and 10, he said, if you confess with your mouth that Jesus Christ is Lord, and you believe in your heart that Jesus Christ died for you, you shall be saved. He said, it is with the mouth that confession is made, and it is with the heart that once believed. So is there anybody that say, I need to make a commitment to Jesus Christ right now? Anybody? Anybody? So everybody here, I have made a confession of Jesus Christ, and if God called you home today, you're going to be in glory, amen? Amen? Because how many of us know, when he called us home, it's too late. You know what I'm saying? But when you wake up and find yourself dead, it's too late. The Bible says today is the day for salvation, amen? Today, praise God, give this young lady a hand, amen? Praise God, can we get the sister over here? Today is the day for salvation. You know what I'm saying? And we can come to church. We can come to church every Sunday, every Wednesday, and still miss God if we don't have a personal relationship with Jesus. Do you know him? Amen? Not know of him. Don't tell me, well, my grandmother told me this. That don't mean squat. Do you know him? Can you say you know him personally? Amen. Praise God. Now, if there's anybody that has not been baptized in the Holy Spirit that would like to be filled and baptized with the Holy Spirit, and really, just me mentioning that, everybody should have ran down. Because some of y'all still have to think about it. Well, Dave, I don't know if I really want that power. I kind of like the way my life is. Well, then you keep it. Praise God. Come on down. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. And if you have faith to believe that God can fill them, I would encourage you to come down and get behind them and pray for them. Amen. And we're going to close out in prayer. Father God, Lord, we just thank you for this time, Father God. I thank you for the privilege, Father God, to glorify and exalt your Son, Jesus the Christ, Father God. And Lord, I just pray for those that came out this evening. I speak life over them, Father God. I pray for a fresh anointing upon their lives, Father God. I pray that you will bless the works of their hand, Father God, and give them traveling mercy, Father God. And Lord, we pray for those that have come forward, Lord, to accept Christ. We pray for those that come forward to be baptized in the Holy Spirit, that you would begin to fill them right now. And if you are able to pray in the Spirit, I encourage you right now to begin to pray for those up here. Praise God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, Lord, fill us with your Holy Spirit, Father God. Fill us, Father God. Oh, Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Right now, God. Lord, fill us up, God. Fill us up, Father God. Lord, we're asking for it, Father God. We're calling on you, Lord. Lord, you say whatever we ask for in your name, it shall be given, Father God. And you're up here, and you believe in God to fill you, begin to cry out now to him. Begin to cry out to him. Use your voice. Begin to cry out to him. Begin to worship him. Oh, hallelujah. Shanda la ba 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 nidaba shanda. Right now, God. Hallelujah. Holy Spirit, have your way. Fill us up, Holy Spirit. Fill us up while we're running over. Fill us up so we can do what you called us to do for your glory, Lord. Right now, Jesus. Right now, Holy Spirit. Come on, Father God. God bless you, young lady. God bless you. Praise you. Right now, God. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, and I encourage you, if you see to begin to pray. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, sha-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta. Oh, shanda-la-ba-ba-ba-ni-da-ba-shanda. Fill us up, God. Lord, we're calling on you, Jesus. Holy Spirit, have your way. Have your way. I pray for a fresh anointing upon our lives. Right now, God. Oh, shandala baba ba nidaba shanda. Oh, shandala baba nidaba shanda. Oh, hallelujah. Glory. 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 Hallelujah. Whoa, shandala baba nidaba shanda. Shandala baba nidaba shanda. Shandala baba baba nidaba shanda. Shandala baba baba nidaba shanda. Shandala baba baba nidaba shanda. Hallelujah. Whoa, right now, God. Right now, God. Oh, have your way, Holy Spirit. Begin to worship him. Begin to glorify him. Give him praise. God is listening. God is waiting on you. Oh, hallelujah. Right now, God. Oh, hallelujah. Begin to praise him, young man. Tell him how wonderful he is. I love him, amen. Whoa, hallelujah. Whoa, shandala ba 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 nidaba shanda. Shandala ba 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 nidaba shanda. Shandala ba 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 nidaba shanda. Shandala ba ba nidaba shanda. Right now, God. We need you, Lord. We need you in our lives. We need you in our marriages. We need you in our families. We need you in our homes. We need you on our jobs. We need you in our church. Right now, God. Right now, God. Oh, hallelujah. Shanda la ba 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 nida ba shanda. Shanda la ba ba nida ba shanda. Oh, he's worthy. He's worthy. He's worthy. I dare you to praise him. 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 I challenge you to praise him. I compel you to praise him. Because he's worthy. And he's waiting on you. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. We serve an awesome God. We serve an awesome God. We serve a living God. We serve a God that's in the room right now. Jesus is here. Jesus is here. Oh, hallelujah. Shanda la baba nina ba shanda. Oh, Holy Spirit, have your way. Have your way. Have your way. Have your way, Spirit of the living God. Spirit of the living God. Oh, shanda la baba nina ba shanda. Oh, praise him. Come on, praise him. Praise him. Praise him. Praise him. Tell him how much you love him. Tell him how much you love him. He's waiting on you. Jesus is waiting on you. I love you, Jesus. I love you, Jesus. I love you, Jesus. Have your way in my life. Have your way in my home. Have your way in my marriage. Have your way in my finances. Have your way with my job. Have your way with my children.